At 6:43 here on Daybreak, and it's a plot that could have been written into a movie. A group of Irish ex-soldiers gather in Buffalo to try to free their homeland.
A movie starring Liam Neeson, I think. Their plan to take Canada and hold it hostage. But it really happened. And as we find out in this unknown story of Western New York, a museum in Fort Erie has the long-lost images that bring the story to life.
A series of paintings lost for nearly a century and a half, illustrating a little-known but vitally important skirmish.
What we're looking at is the birth of a nation, aren't we?
We sure are. These are 23 original watercolor paintings.
The paintings tell the story of the 1866 Fenian invasion of Canada.
When the Irish invaded, it was like a terrorism attack in a foreign country.
It was a group of Irish expats who concocted a scheme. Much of the planning is said to have been done in a tavern in the old First Ward. Some accounts say it was this German hotel on Chicago Street, and two of the paintings seem to depict that. The Fenians, mostly Irish veterans of the American Civil War, invaded Ontario from Buffalo as part of a plan to hold British North America, now known as Canada, hostage until England got out of Ireland. The only crossing occurred at this point near the foot of Hurdle. A monument stands there today.
At that point in time, we weren't Canada yet. We were still part of Great Britain, relying on Great Britain for our defenses, and those defenses didn't come through.
The Irish forces met with Canadian and British troops in the Battle of Ridgeway and were defeated. But while the skirmish might be little known to Western New Yorkers, its impact was monumental.
It really caused panic in the citizenship to put pressure on politicians that perhaps we should be a country and have our own defense system, defend ourselves, because who knows when we could be invaded again. And that really got the politicians moving, and Confederation happened a year later.
And it was all captured on canvas by a Toronto artist named Alexander von Erickson, who had heard the rumors of the invasion.
So he came down with the Canadian soldiers and painted what was happening.
And by the looks of the paintings, spent quite a bit of time here.
He must have been here because the topography is dead on to the buildings that are some still standing today.
But these pictures were unknown for decades.
It was in the early 1990s when I learned of them.
When a historian 550 miles from Ridgeway put two and two together.
They were sitting in a museum in Newport News, Virginia. And because the Fenians were wearing Civil War uniforms, that museum was trying to link these activities to a battle during the Civil War, and it just didn't match.
Once they figured out that it wasn't the Civil War, but the Fenian invasion, the owners contacted Jane Davies at the Fort Erie Historical Museum. The museum found a sponsor and was able to purchase the entire collection.
I was flabbergasted at these things. They're beautiful images.
Images of a battle intent on freeing one nation, but instead creating another. And another chapter in the unknown stories of Western New York.
It is so great that those paintings are back where they belong.
Yeah.
In Western New York.
And you've probably passed by it on your way to Crystal Beach, the Ridgeway Battlefield. It's right there on Garrison Road as you're heading to Crystal Beach. So next time, take a look at the sign and say, hey, and check out those paintings.
Thanks to your story, Pete. Thank you. It is.